Today, we will be making a tea towel dress. What is a tea towel? In the olden days, you can call them a tea towel, you can call them like a flour sack, but the ones I have in mind, the towel version usually was used to dry. It's like a towel we have now, like this, just not as like absorbent. You dry like nicer things with them. This dress was inspired by this one designer. I'll put up her work here. She's really great. Go buy this dress from her. She does a really good job. Inspired me. Mine is not gonna look as good as hers. Like, I don't know. She does such a good job of getting like all these funky colors to like go together and snaps. I'm gonna give you a little haul of our tea towels. So these, I'm gonna show you the ones that I got first, which I got from antique shop. First one is from 1976. It's super cute. It has a lot of birds. I hate birds, but they got birds on them. Here's my second one, which I believe is this flower sack. And I forgot to mention that it has the dates. That's the ones that I really think are super duper cute. Are the ones that have like the little dates, the calendar at the bottom. But this one is a flower sack, because you can tell because there's two of them. So it used to be sewn like this. It's giving me Kit Kittredge. And this is another tea towel. And this is from 1981. And I like it because it kind of goes with the birds theme that we're going with. These are some that I got from my great aunt that she gave me. And they don't really have the calendars and stuff, but they're really sweet. I still think they're super cute. I probably will use this one. That's enough for the intro. But one last thing I do want to say is like, my plan is when I get this dress done, where I always love to do like a little photo shoot to kind of like get some good photos of my work. My plan is we have a farmhouse that I used to live in when I was younger that my brother is living in currently. A really beautiful house. It was built in 1939? Somewhere around there. I will correct myself if I'm wrong, which I probably am. I need to stop talking. Hi guys. It's literally been a week since last time I filmed, and I haven't done anything to this dress. Okay, to be fair, I impulsively made this dress, which is what I decided. It's kind of like the mock-up for this one, but I just ended up making the whole entire dress because I wanted to, and I had to wear it to a band concert, and I wanted to wear it for like Mother's Day and stuff. Also, my sewing room looks so bad because it is a storage room. Hence why it's like terrible. I literally have one singular light bulb and a lamp. Pattern. We're talking about patterns now. So how I got this pattern was, this is my birthday dress. It's from Jay Ng, if you're wondering. But I'm gonna say, literally came in like three sizes and did not fit. Literally, like, just did not fit my bust. And basically what I did was I just manipulated a bunch, make it fit my bust, and then also added straps because there's no straps on here, but I just got the basic outline from that to make the pattern for this one, which I did make. I made this dress, like I said, and this is kind of what I want. I want this dress, but longer, essentially. So what I did for that one, I might just make a few little tweaks to this, but I shortened this. Because my Valentine's Day dress, I lengthened it to be a little bit of a longer empire waist. So this, it's kind of ratchet, but what I do is I just put it on wrapping paper. Okay, I'm going to give you guys a really quick what's happening. This was the top, cut it off, took this from the bottom, but I think it looks super cute. Other than like the green looks kind of awkward, but it's not even going to be in the pattern. But look how cute. I love the little flowers on it. We have this so far. We cut out all the pieces. I don't even know if I showed that, to be honest. Alright, I'm just gonna explain it a little better. So basically, all you're gonna do is cut out all your pattern pieces once in your main fabric for your outer layer, and again for your lining layer. And so when you put them all together, they'll kind of look like this. Cut out the lining pieces, which is this, like, it's not a lime green, but it's like a lighter green. I think I'll look good with that. Should have been recording this. I totally forgot. Maybe I'll do better. And so basically I tea-dyed these, like very lightly tea-dyed, just so it's a little bit off-white. And I sewed along these sides, and I haven't even clipped my seams or anything yet. We're just getting them on here. Did the princess seams. Like this. The next thing, I'm just gonna connect these. I don't know if I said this, but I piecemealed.
piecemeal.
Like this. This is like four different pieces of fabric. So what you'll do is just line it up. Whenever you're sewing, you have the pretty side to pretty side. So right side to right side fabric. And then you sew. And then when you flip it out, bam. But yeah, I kind of like it. It's very fun. We're going to sew these together now. But here's my serger. It's the Singer SO100. What I'm going to do is, I actually attached all the pieces. And I mean, all you're doing is just doing a straight seam. Any piece where this, so this seam and this seam where this like different, this woven towel is, I'm just going to run over it with a serger. In simple words, I was just overlocking where the fabric was fraying. The entirety of this done, I have my lining. It fits pretty good. I feel like some of my princess seams could have been a tad bit better, but we're not going to be too hard on ourselves. Pretty side to like pretty side, which is this side, not of course this side. Slide the straps in here, and then I'm going to do a big long stitch. All right, for the straps, I cut them at a slant, 4.5 inches wide by 28 inches long. I folded them in half, sewed along the side, and then I flipped them inside out, and I did a top stitch, and that was pretty much it. Those measurements can change depending on what you would like, but it worked out for me. Okay, this can be kind of tricky to understand, but once you get it, it'll be pretty easy. So you're gonna just take both right sides of your lining and your outer bodice and place them together, and then you just take your four straps and put the raw edge along that side that you're gonna have that seam, and just stitch from the top and the sides, and you'll just flip it out and you'll have your bodice. I talked to you yesterday, and then I went and saw the new Downton Abbey movie, which was really good. I'm out of school now, so I need to still like tack together. I also decided I'm gonna add pockets. In total, I have six. These I all got except for that one for my local antique store, and that one my aunt gave me. She gave me even more. So this one will be in the front center. This one's gonna be to the side of the front. And then you come over here, and these will be in the back, and that's gonna be in the middle back, if that makes any sense. But I just laid them out because I need to get the length of how long they are, just to see, like, for the ruffle at the bottom, how big to make it, etc. It's pretty self-explanatory, but you're just gonna have three tea towels you sew for the front and three for the back, but make sure you just don't connect them yet because we're gonna add pockets later. What I'll do next is I have these three towels. We sew those really quickly, and then we'll start on the pockets. So.
Please don't talk about me when I'm gone. Oh, honey, though our friendship ceases from now on. And listen, if you can't say anything real nice, it's better not to talk at all, is my advice.
Now here are my skirt towel pieces. Never made inseam pockets before this, but I thought they were pretty easy. So basically for your pattern piece, you're gonna want to have this kind of soybean shape. It doesn't have to be perfect, but just make sure it's the width of your hand and can fit your phone inside. So you're gonna cut four pieces of that out, and you're gonna distribute two amongst your two skirt pieces, and you're really gonna want to make sure that you evenly distribute them, so a few inches down from your skirt, since this is an empire waist. And for me, you can just see me just measuring and just really making sure that they are equal. And then we're gonna go to the sewing machine, right sides together. We're going to sew all the four pockets onto the two panels, and then right sides together, we're gonna sew around the perimeter of both skirts. And we're gonna make sure that we sew around the pockets. Yeah, and I like how you can see me watching Downton Abbey.
The pockets are done.
The skirt is gonna... Oh, there you are. There's a pocket. So here's what we're doing now. Here's my top. I'm not wearing the correct bra, so it looks weird. Probably will give us a tad bit of trim. Measurements of my ruffle, basically it is twice
the length of your tea towels altogether. So my tea towels were 91, so 182 is my ruffle length. And I made it 13 inches wide, so it hit me at a tee length. But I cut two pieces of 91 inches and 13 wide, and so I sewed them together so they would be in total 182 inches. And then I just ironed them out, and then I also ironed a hem because it's going to be going at the bottom of the dress and we want to get that hem out of the way while it's flat. So I sewed that hem, and then after that I sewed two gathering stitches on the opposite side of the fabric that I'm going to use to gather the ruffle. But you do that by just sewing that with your longest stitch length and then gathering the threads at the end. So as you can see, I just gathered that ruffle, and so what I was doing here was just pinning and equally distributing the gathers amongst the skirt, right sides together. And then I just ended up sewing a long stitch, being very careful not to snag any other bits of the fabric while I sewed. Show you. Oh, look at Gibby. Kind of laid out. This is obviously going to be gathered, but I hope you can see my vision now. Some people might look at this and be like, oh my lord, that is the ugliest shit I've ever seen in my life. I get it. It's okay. Snagged it a little bit here, so I'm just going to seam right that out. Also forgot to say, I'm going to pull out our basting stitches. So it's actually a really crisp seam, so. Finished it with my serger at the bottom. Just gonna right side to right side like this, flip it like that, and pin it together, and then sew.
I'm just gonna explain it because I really didn't take any good videos for the end, but I'm just gonna tell you. So first you're gonna start off by just gathering the tea towel skirt section, and you're just going to do that by again having a gathering stitch at the top, gathering that up, and then next all you're going to do is right sides together, put your bodice and line it up, and sew across the top. Alright, and then the end is pretty easy. You just add an invisible zipper and then sew up the sides. And I mean, I really did not show you how to sew up an invisible zipper, but I'm sure there's lots of tutorials out there.
Heaven, I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak, and I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven, I'm in heaven,